Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel SJR Comtech. In last video, explain how to convert the decimal number to the binary as well as decimal to the octal and hexadecimal. But those are only integer values we converted into the another number system. Today we are going to see how to convert the decimal fraction to binary, in which I am going to explain you two examples. The same process is followed, but I will take two examples to make you understand. Suppose the given decimal number is 9.125. So here 9 is the integer part and 0.125 is the fractional part. Already I explained in one of my video how to convert the integer part into the binary. You can go through that video. In description box already I mentioned that link for that particular video. So how to convert this 9 into the binary? The same process, divided by 2 until we don't get the result quotient as 0, and collect all the remainders from bottom to top. So this is how we can convert the integer part to the binary. Now we are going to focus how to convert the fractional part into the binary. Now here, what is difference? Instead of dividing, we have to multiply that fractional part by 2 until we don't get the fractional part as a 0. So here the fractional part is 0.125. So fraction is 0.125, multiply it by 2. So we will get the result as 0.250. Now here the fractional part of the result is not 0. So what we will do? We will write this integer part of this result here and select the fractional part only and write here. Now in the next step, again take this fractional part and multiply it by 2. When we multiply it by 2, you will get the result as 0.500. Here again, what is the integer part? Integer part is 0. So write this part here and select the fractional part only, that is 0.500. Write it here. Now in the next step, again what we have to do? We have to take this fractional part, multiply this fractional part with 2 and write the result. Now when we multiply this 0.500 by 2, we will get the result as 1.000. Now here you can see the integer part is 1 and the fractional part is 0. So now this is the stage where we got the fractional part as a 0. So now we will stop the process of multiplying by 2 to the fractional part, because even though if you continue, what will happen? Fractional part is 0. If we multiply this fractional part with 2, again we will get the result 0. So in each next stage we are going to get the result 0. So we have to stop the process when we are getting fraction as 0. Now when we converted the decimal integer into the binary, that time we collected all these remainders from bottom to top. So first of all, here we will write the binary equivalent of the 9, and that is 1001. So write 1001. After that, this point is there, decimal point is there. Okay, now we have to write the binary equivalent for this fractional part, 125. So how to write? Here you can see this integer column is there. Every time whenever we are getting the result after multiplication of fractional part with 2, we have written this integer into integer column. So that is 0, 0 and 1. So now we will write all these integer values from top to bottom, and those are 0, 0, 1. So this is the binary equivalent of this 9.125 decimal. First step, convert the integer number by dividing by 2. Collect remainder from bottom to top. Now done with the integer number. Now what is left? Only fractional part. So take the fractional part, multiply it by 2, get the result, see the result, and write only integer part in the integer column and write the fractional part of that result in the fraction column. Okay. Now, if the fractional part is not 0, then what we are supposed to do? Again, take that part into the next step and multiply it by 2. Again, write the result. result. Select only integer part. Write in the integer column. Here in short I have written INT for the integer. And take the fractional part and write in the fraction column. See whether it is 0. If it is not 0, again take it to the next line. Multiply that fractional part with 2. Get the result. Now here you can see the result is 1.000. So the integer part is 1 and the fractional part is 0. So now there is no sense in multiplying this fractional part with 2 again, because again if you multiply again you are going to get the result as 0 only. So stop this process here and collect all these integer values from top to bottom and write here the result 1001.001, which is binary equivalent of the decimal 9.125. Now to make it better understand, I want to take one more example. How to convert the fractional part of the decimal to the binary. Okay, see 0.225. So the fractional part is 0.225. Again the same process. Here write the fractional part 0.225. Multiply it with 2. Here we will write the result, that is 0.450. Now what is the integer part of this? That is 0. So write it in integer column and write this fractional part in last column, that is fraction column. Now see, is this fraction 0? No, it is not 0. So what we will do, we will take this to the next line, multiply that fractional part again with 2, the result is 0.900. So here the integer is 0, so write 0 and this is the fractional part, write in the fraction column. Again see, this is not 0. So again the same process continue. Take it to the next line, multiply it with 2, result will be 1.8. So this 1 is the integer part, write in the integer column, and this 0.8 is fraction. So write it here in the fraction. Next 0.8, write in the next line, multiply it with 2, the result will be 1.6. Again the integer is 1 and the fractional part is 0.6. Again it is not 0. So write it to the next line, 0.6 multiply by 2, the result will be 1.2. And integer part of this number is 1 and the fractional part is 0.2. Now again write it to the next line, 0.2 multiply by 2, so the result will be 0.4. Here integer part is 0, fractional part is 0.4. Again here also we didn't get the fraction as 0. So again continue the process. 0.4 multiply by 2 equal to 0.8. Its integer part is 0 and its fractional part is 0.8. Again now write it to the next line. 0.8 into 2 equal to 1.6. Here this 1 is the integer part, write in the integer column, and 0.6 is the fractional part, so write it here. But now you see this 0.8 and 0.6 is here also, isn't it? 0.8 and 0.6 is here also. So if we continue the same process, what is going to happen? We got the 0.8, then 0.6. After this, if I continue the same process, I will get the 0.2, 0.8. And again, I will get the same loop again and again until and unless I don't stop the process of multiplying with 2. That means this loop of getting 0.8, 0.6, 0.2 and 0.4 is going to continue until we continue the process of multiplying till infinity. So this is the example where we will never get the fractional part as 0. So in some of the example we will get the fractional part as 0, that is okay. But when some example or some decimal numbers are given there where we are not getting the fractional part as 0, so we have to stop at that point where we understand, yes, this is the loop of these 4 fractional numbers that is going to repeat again and again until I continue the process. Okay, so now we can stop this process here only and now collect all these integer numbers from top to bottom. And so here write 0.2 0.00 then 111001 from top to bottom these numbers we have to write after this point and here 0 is given so 0.00111001 so we should understood yes this is the particular loop this is going to repeat again and again so now there is no sense in continuing this process so stop the process and write the equivalent binary as it is binary write the base as 2 so these are the two examples in which in first example we are getting the fractional part as 0 and in second one we will never get the fractional part as 0 but stop the process when the same loop is going to continue so this is only about the decimal fraction to binary conversion so if you like this video please click on like subscribe my channel and click on the bell icon also to get the uploaded to get the notification of my next uploaded videos thank you